the obstacles to building a post-carbon society are principally social and political, they are not economic or technological. We have the capacity, we have the resources, and we have the history. Transformative political action and leadership is entirely missing. It is necessary and possible, and it has arisen before at times of crisis. Climate is now the biggest crisis of them all, which requires a great social and economic overturning, a revolt against the corporate interest, the cultural comfort, and the political incapacity that will drive us to catastrophe sooner than most of us understand if we do not act with great urgency. As Gramsci said, the challenge of modernity is to live without illusions, optimism of the will. And so I think the challenge for each and every one of us today is in fact a moral choice. And it is simply this: what will we do today, tomorrow, and in the following days, in our personal lives and politically, to face the climate challenge and build a society and a planet fit for succeeding generations?
The World Social Forum started in 2001. It was essentially planned as a gathering of civil society to bring together the big social movements, non-government organizations, campaigns, and the like that are contesting neoliberalism. Neoliberalism is the ideology of global unfettered markets, or some people call it corporate globalization. And it was meant to actually bring the key actors together under this banner, Another World is Possible, that would catalyze a new vision or new visions for the world that we live in.
The World Economic Forum is a big old business festival that happens in Davos usually every year, where lots of bigwigs get together with lots of money, with a nice closed door, and discuss things that we don't know about that will affect our everyday life. And the World Social Forum was an antithesis to that, a place where anyone can get in, anyone can talk.
The World Social Forum was a counterpoint to that, so it was meant to really create a kind of to say, okay, well, we're going to have the event at the same time, but we're going to hold it in the South, and it's going to be open to anyone who wants to come participate about talking about creating another world, and we're going to bring all the people that are trying to change the world.
Outro mundo é possível.
Een andere wereld is mogelijk.
Een andere wereld is possível.
Another world is possible.
After 2001, the World Social Forum took off. It was so popular. It went from 2001. It went from 10,000 people. 2002 to 50,000 people. 2003 to 100,000. And in Mumbai, when it moved to Mumbai in 2004, it reached about 130,000 people. So there was an explosion, essentially, of civil society coming together. In parallel with that is that groups around the world just said, well, we want a social forum in our area. You know, we have people here campaigning for different things that are pushing for another way of living, new ways of organizing social life, work, politics, whatever. So since 2001, there's been over 200 social forums held in over 120 cities around the world. So it's a quite diverse process. It's still going on.
So the Melbourne Social Forum, we're kind of like,
what we do is we create an open space and we invite different environmental and social groups in Melbourne to come in and fill it. So these groups are already working on solutions to problems that we're facing today, and so the Melbourne Social Forum provides a space for them to come in and tell the public about what's going on. It also provides a really good opportunity for all those groups to network together, and so we're all working together, all moving to the same direction for environmental justice, social justice, and a better world.
Well, a very important concept in social forums is open space, or open space process. And essentially what that means is that people are given the opportunity to construct the forum space the way that they want to do it.
So the ability for the Melbourne Social Forum and the Hot House Festival to firstly reach out to people at the individual level and get them to change their individual behaviour, so doing those little things we know we should all be doing, and then at the community level by engaging with the community, and further the next level up, the political level, which is really where it's at. We need to get people out there actually, you know, forming movements and pressuring our politicians to take stances on issues that represent what the majority of people think and knows right. From an Australian point of view, with perhaps a lot of affluence and perhaps the media here is not so independent, I guess it's very difficult to say that the Melbourne Social Forum and an Australian Social Forum movement, if one was to form, would actually be able to have the same reach that the social forums have had all around the world. But there's definitely the potential there, and we're all doing our best.
Spreading the word of peace, because it's in a sustainable space and it helps people to see that this is what the future could look like. That's why the environment here is really a powerful environment to start to cultivate a culture of peace.
Every country in the world is going to have to open their heart.
Getting people to start talking again. And once people, a large enough group of people start talking, we'll be able to find the people that we need to change this world, change our way of thinking.
An environmental perspective, turn your power off. Don't consume more than you need. Think about what you're doing. Think about how it affects the environment. Think about the fact that everything is finite.
A good way to start is go home. Anything you haven't used for a year, get rid of it. You won't have to clean it anymore and you won't have to look after it. If you want to buy something that you really want and think about it for a week. Lay by it, anticipate it, enjoy it. You know, try to find ways of living in the world that bring other people in.
Helping people to see that we are part of a community and we're here to have a voice, you know, and we have a right to that voice.
Well, another world is possible and another world is happening, and I think that's what people are finding all around, is that as we grow and as we learn, there's a movement that's coming through, and people want that change. People want to live more sustainably. Nobody wants to tread on anyone else's human rights, and we're getting there.